Hi, and welcome to the Nature Reunion. I'm Christine Agro, and today I want to talk to you about the five key energies in nature. When I do my work, I'm looking at the common threads that we can find in nature that help us to learn and heal and grow in our own growth and awareness. And so over the years, I've been exploring and looking at nature and looking at the different patterns and the way that nature moves through its different cycles and its seasons. And I found these five key energies, which are ground, align, flow, open or expand, and spiral. And so, with ground, we're talking about our ability to root ourselves into the earth and like a tree and get that really strong support and foundation and nourishment that we see trees have. So, if we bring that element of grounding into our own life, it creates a sense of safety and security and stability and a place from which we can move forward with that certainty, with that connection, that strong rootedness into the earth. With align, again, I saw that in looking at trees and in the way that they are aligned with their own spiritual sense of self. And actually, all of nature has that same kind of dynamic. It exists within its own framework, and it does what it needs to do in alignment with its own purpose. So we don't see, I think my favorite thing to say is that we don't see the elm tree looking at the oak tree and saying, "Oh, I wish I had those leaves," or "I wish I was more like that," or the conifer looking at the deciduous tree and wishing that it would, go through a change of seasons and drop its leaves and flower and all those things. So there is that sort of natural alignment with soul purpose that exists within each aspect of nature. And so we can look to nature and experience our own natural alignment or enhance or better understand our own alignment with our own spirit. With flow, we're looking at water and we're looking at water's ability to move and find its way around and through any obstacle that is put into its path. There is just a natural, continual movement that happens with water. And so, if we look at that in our own space, our entire body, about 60% of it is water. And yet, we really more readily identify with the more solid form of ourselves and get locked into the obstacles that exist. So if we can align ourselves with the flow that is inherent in our own beings and move and allow ourselves to move more fluidly, it creates a very flowing, fluid response in our own growth and our own life. With open and expand, I think, these are similar energies, but open, particularly when I was looking at flowers in slow motion, I realized that they just don't open. They actually open in stages. So they start to open, they take a pause, they open a little bit more, they take a pause, they open a little bit more, and then they're fully open. I think when we think about our own growth and we think about projects that we're working on and our steps forward, we think that it should be a constant, straightforward line that doesn't stop. And when we hit that pause, it creates a sense of anxiety and stress for us. So if we can align ourselves with this key energy of nature, of how nature opens and expands, then we can have that in our own lives. We can recognize that when we hit that pause, it's an opportunity to collect up our energy before we move forward again. And then with spiral, we're talking about a very ingrained natural part of our existence, which is the spiral energy. And we see that in so many different places. And what I find, there's two things with spiral when I work with it. Spiral in our lives gives us the opportunity to do our work in this kind of notion. So rather than a linear from point A to point B, we're moving in this spiral dynamic. And what it offers us is the ability to be at point B and see and reflect back to point A. We see that in communications. A lot of times you may be in conversation where there's many conversations going on at once, and you have the ability to keep the thread of all of them because of this spiral energy that we work on. So we're going to connect to the natural pattern of spiral, which has this growth movement of expanding out. And we're also going to use it in movement classes to twist and sort of squeeze out anything that's sort of stuck in our space. So those are the five key energies, and I just wanted to touch base with you on those and give you a little bit of insight. I did do a whole radio show on the five key energies at Nature Speak, so I'm also going to share that and post it underneath this, so you can get a little bit more information if you're interested in more depth about, you know, what these five key energies are. So I hope that this supports you, and I'll see you again.